Hi guys, hope all of you are doing well. Right, so guys, in the last class we had studied the concept of cost of goods consumed, which is called as COGC, which is also known as cost of materials consumed. Okay guys, so every organization invariably at some point of the time have to purchase these materials. The intention of purchasing these materials is not only resale, majorityly it will be for consumption. Intention would be for consumption. Now consumption means it could be for two kind of people. One is for own members. Another one is for non-members. Right? So let's take an example that let's say I have a sports club. I have the 300 members as a part of the organization, and we have opening stock of worth 10,000 rupees sports materials. This could be like bat, ball, etc. Okay, so during the year we went to purchase about further materials for, let's say, 40,000 rupees. So total expenditure incurred for the year should be 50,000 rupees. Of course, in this 50,000, some I would have paid in cash, some I would have gotten credit. That doesn't matter. So ultimately, this is the amount of 50,000 which I have incurred as expense. Okay, now I cannot record entire 50,000 rupees as expenditure in expenditure account. The reason being, of this 50,000 worth sports material, I would have consumed few and I have not consumed few. So I would have still had certain materials left in my stock. Let's say 20,000. Which means 20,000 worth sports material are still lying in my warehouse, totally unused. So balance 30,000 worth sports materials are used. When I say used, these are taken from the warehouse or the storeroom, and it has been actually used by the members for their practice. Or I would have distributed to the non-members, which means those people, those are not part of the organization, I would have still distributed them free of cost. Right, so the concept says that you cannot record entire 50,000 as your expenditure, because 20,000 worth goods you still hold in your hands. So in expenditure account you can take only 30,000 as your expenditure. So this is the amount that would reflect in my income and expenditure account as sports material consumed equal to 30,000 in expenditure column. Right guys, I hope this makes sense. So with this understanding, let's proceed to illustration 17, which is on page number 1.29. So illustration 17 says, calculate the amount of medicines consumed during the year ended 31st March 2019. So opening stock of medicines is 50,000 rupees. Closing stock of medicines is 45,000 more than opening stock. Amount paid for medicines during the year is 2 lakh rupees. Opening creditors 20,000. Closing creditor is 50% of the opening creditors. Okay. Now what is the requirement? Calculation of medicines consumed. This is the requirement. Okay, so what is my opening stock? Opening stock is equal to rupees 50,000. Okay. So with this, I would add my purchase. But in question, purchase amount is not explicitly or clearly given, so we would wait. What would the total amount to? This is the total expenditure incurred. This is total expenditure incurred during financial year. So with this, I would reduce closing stock. What is my closing stock? It says closing stock is 45,000 more than opening stock. So 50,000 is my opening stock. So my closing stock is 45,000 more extra with this 50,000. So this becomes 95,000 is my total closing stock. Okay. So the resultant figure should be cost of material consumed. This ideally would go to my expenditure account. Now, the question is not clear with regard to the purchases, but they have given some additional information. It says, amount paid for medicines during the year. Amount paid. Amount paid for medicines is equal to 2 lakh rupees. So this amount is paid for the purpose of medicine. It is clearly given in the question. Now you can take the entire 2 lakh rupees as your purchase cost, or just give a thought to what I am saying. I have further information which says that opening creditor is 20,000 rupees and closing creditor is 50,000 of opening creditors. Now this makes me think that entire 2 lakh rupees should not be my purchase. Okay, the question says that it has opening creditor worth 20,000. And closing creditor is equal is 50% of opening creditor. So 50% of 20,000 should be 10,000. So creditor from opening 20,000, which means in the beginning of the financial year, we were supposed to pay the creditor 20,000 rupees. Now the balance left over is only 10,000. So which means 10,000 should have been paid. So don't you think this 10,000 which is paid to creditor should be a part of this 2 lakh also? So which means this 2 lakh is not only the payment made for the medicines in the current year, it is also indicating the payment made to the made for the medicines to the creditors of the previous years also. So what I'm trying to do is, so this is the amount paid for procuring the medicines during the current year. So my intention is, my intuition is that this 2 lakh payment which has been made for two purposes. One is for purchasing current year's medicine, and a part of this has been paid to creditors who have supplied me this medicine which belonged to previous year. Because obviously if I have made payment for the opening creditors, the purchase should have been happened in the previous year. So I'm minusing less payment to creditor of previous year, which is 10,000 rupees. So balance 119,000 rupees is the amount that we have incurred or we have made for purchasing the current year's medicine exclusively, right? So the purchase should be 190,000. So 190 plus 50 amounts to 140,000. So these 140,000 rupees is the total expense incurred during the financial year. But of this 140,000 worth medicines, 95,000 worth medicine is still there as my stock, which means I have not consumed it. So I cannot record entire 1,40,000 as expenditure. So with that, I have to minus that stock which I have still in my hand. So the balance left is, sorry, 150 plus 190 is 240. Sorry, my mistake. So my opening stock is 50. Purchase made during there is 190. So this amounts to 2,40,000 rupees. Okay, so which means during the entire year we have incurred rupees 2,40,000 for medicines. Of this 2,40,000 rupees, 95,000 medicines is still there in my stock. So the goods, the cost of medicines that has been consumed is worth 1,45,000 rupees. No doubt I have spent money, or my expenditure I have incurred to the extent of 2,40,000 rupees, but I cannot record entire 2,40,000 as expenditure because 95,000 worth medicines are still lying in my stock. So this 90,000 I'll record as expense only in that year in which I consume them. So out of this 240, 95 is unconsumed. This is unconsumed. Balance 1,45,000 has been consumed. So my cost of material consumed that should go to my income and expenditure account is 1,45,000. Guys, I hope this is clear. I would also show you an alternative method on how do we derive this purchase of 1,90,000 rupees. This alternative method is widely used in all your upcoming sums. So listen me out very carefully. So it goes this way. So the moment the creditors information is given, please open creditors ledger. Creditors ledger. Creditors is liability. Liability being credit balance. I'll have my opening always on the credit side. So opening creditor is 20,000. And they're given as closing creditor, which is 50% of opening creditor, which is nothing but 10,000 rupees. They have given the question that amount paid for medicines during the year. So please tell me, if I make the payment to the creditors, what will be the journal entry? So creditors, to close creditors, I'll be giving them a debit. So creditors account debit to bank. 2 lakh, 2 lakh. So in creditors to bank or cash, this is 2 lakh rupees. So if you see on my debit side, I have in total 2,10,000 rupees, whereas on my credit side is only 20,000 rupees. So the resultant balancing figure should be 1,90,000 rupees. Now guys, please tell me, if creditors is having credit balance, to increase my creditors, I have to keep giving a credit. So on my credit side, I am having 1,90,000 rupees. So what should this be? Creditors increase only on account of credit purchase. So the entry for this should have been purchase account debit to creditors, which is nothing but 1,90,000 and 1,90,000. So when I record on creditors ledger, this should be by credit purchase 1,90,000 rupees, right? So this is how we have identified what is the purchase that has been made during the year, which means this indicates that during the year I had to pay the creditors 20,000 rupees. Further, I have made purchases for 1,90,000 rupees. So the total payment that I have to make to the creditors is 2,10,000 rupees. Of this 2,10,000 rupees, 2 lakh has been paid. The balance unpaid is 10,000. Right? Guys, this is how we derive the purchases made during the year. So I hope the question is clear. So with this, we come to end of illustration 17.